Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Indigo Tarot Odyssey. If you're new to this channel, welcome, welcome. We have a lot of fun over here, and I specialize in picker card reads because people tend to like those a lot. And if you're one of our regulars, welcome, and thank you guys so much for your beautiful comments. Like this morning, I was literally just crying. I had so much gratitude in my heart for you guys, and we're connecting, and a lot of you comment daily, so I really feel connected to you. So it's making my channeling stronger toward you too. So I'm starting to get, like, being an empath, your pains, I'm feeling where you have pains on my body. So I'm starting to research some stuff for you guys as well. There's some new breakthroughs with this new acupuncture laser pen that is amazing, and it's really inexpensive, and it does some really cool things. So I'm going to do some research for you guys and have some stuff delivered to my house, do some practice runs with some stuff, and see if we can get over it, because I know a lot of you have really physical jobs and it pains you. So I want to do a pick a card read for you of what areas of your life are you going to see big improvements and growth in, because that's what I was I had a lineup of stuff I was going to do, but I was sitting here and I was talking to my daughter, and she was talking about her work, and I thought, wow, that makes a really good topic there. Because, you know, we want some of our new words and our vocabulary to change, right? We want merry, overjoyed, jubilant, happy, delighted, blissful, blithe, jolly, laughing, looking good, perky, playful, sunny, all those things that make things joyous, happy, light, and free, right? Where we're tired of the heavy, we're tired of the dark. We don't want to go back. We don't want to be in the past. We don't want to think of anything that pulls us into a darker emotional state. We want to move into the light, which is the present, because that's when everything happens. That's when we feel everything. That's when we know our guides are with us. That's when we feel things, and we have a capacity to love at our greatest, because we're not having to, like, jerk ourselves back to reality, because we're already making plans for tomorrow. We're into next week, right? And that happens a lot around Christmas time, because we are excited, and we tend to check out, right? People are talking to us, and then we just hear wah, 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 like Charlie Brown, wah, wah. I've had people, I've carried on entire conversations with somebody, walked away and not remember a friggin' thing they've been talking about, because I'm in my head, I'm channeling, I'm talking to guys, I'm doing my own thing. And then I was like, oh my goodness, what if they were saying things like, oh, my mother just passed away and this, that. And I was like, oh, uh-huh. I heard it as they were saying it, so I'm sure I gave appropriate answers, but it went out the out window the second I stopped. So again, where can we make areas of improvement? And I'm going to grab a quick animal card for you to be able to choose from. So we have, oh, this is Dara Doe's favorite. She's a skunk spirit. So you get skunk spirit, frog spirit, lion spirit, elephant spirit. So you can choose from these 1, 2, 3, 4. Where can you expect areas improvement? And some of you, quantum leap time. I was feeling it last night. I'm sleeping so erratically and I'm hardly getting any rest, because I'm really having strong connections, and also the physical aspect with you guys when I deal with you on a daily basis. So I have these, like, just massive premonitions and stuff like that, and I have to relax my mind and disconnect and ground. I've been working a little too hard. I don't think I've taken a day off since I've started this, because I've had private reads every day. I've either videotaped, done something tarot related. I think I've only had one day off, and I do need to give my whole system a rest from it, because I can start to be like, well, although I'm blessed and I can't complain, it becomes a little taxing. So I got to step back a little. So if you've decided number one is for you, the skunk spirit, know your worth. Don't say yes when you mean no. Don't give away your time freely or cheaply. Value what you do. If you're a craftsman or somebody of any of those sorts, know your worth. Your time is valuable, and so is your skill set. So be aware of that, and that's where you're going to see improvement too. You're going to be like, hell, why am I setting my personal prices so low for things that I make? You know, whether it's art, whether it's you know, you're doing things like giving you're painting murals, anything that you're doing for people. We always have family and friends that recognize that we have certain skill sets, right? And they will want things from us. It's human nature, because we all share and share alike. But however, don't give away what has value, because it's your time and we all need to make a living, right? I mean, I've always done, like, some pro bono stuff, especially for people that have no money, they're in need, but I especially connect with those people. Otherwise, I would be giving free reads around the clock, and I would not be earning a living, right? So we have to know that our time is valuable, and give yourself a fair premium for what you do, because you're gifted and you're going to start to know that. Look at this, self-worth. So yeah, you guys, you're definitely making air. What? You're definitely, look at that. Know your worth and self-worth. This is your area of improvement. You know who you are. You're stepping up. You're stepping into your power, and you know that you have value. You know you have a valuable skill set. I cast off all concerns about people and what they think about me. I know I'm a totally kick-ass person. And my kick-assedness can never be diminished by rejection. So people can think what they think, feel what they feel. In the meantime, I keep on knowing I know what I know without thinking about what they know or what they think I know. Absolutely, right? Look at that, too, self-worth. That's you. You're stepping into your own, to your own personal power and going, wow, you know, I have skill sets. I am of value. What I make, do, say, and how I live my life has value. And you're no longer going to accept less, which is beautiful. And that's very important. Winter, take care of your needs. Again, this is the knowing your worth. You're going to pamper yourself. You're going to go get that manicure, pedicure. When you have that little bit of extra money, you're not going to have frivolity take over and be like, oh, here, because you rarely spend on yourself. I feel like a lot of you're going to make sure your kid always had this extra thing, this and that, and everybody, or that you picked up the check. Not now. Now is the time for you to care for you and you be in the receiving mode for what you work for, right? And have, because you realize you're worth it, right? Ooh, I sold dying love. So that's another area that you're going to have some improvements is I feel like your private interactions with people, and you're going to become more magnetic and open to love right now too. So let me see if I can read that. The love you have shared is eternal regardless of the situation. Yeah, I feel like once the starting point is with ourselves. So when we learn to love ourselves and care for ourselves, we teach others how to treat us, right? So if we show people that we have value in our own eyes and as an energetic entity that is emotional and has needs and things like that, and we take care and we step back and we value that, we teach other people to do that as well. It's very important. And Diana talks about focused intention. Keep your unwavering thoughts, feelings, and actions focused on your target, and you will make your mark. So again, you're not concerned about other people and people, places, or things, or keeping up or having your ego involved. It's all about your focus and your goal. And to do that, you need to maintain your focus so you're not distracted by all these other little things, that you're just going for it. That's beautiful, you guys. So yeah, you're caring for yourselves. You're learning to value yourself, your time, understand your self-worth, which is very important, because when people just think you're there for them and you become caretaker, it's exhausting and there's very little reward in that, because people start to delve into the entitlement center. Like, where's my lunch? Where's my this and that? I'll tell you where your lunch is. It's at the store where you can go get it. You know what I mean? I don't put up with that for a second. I'm a giver, giver, giver. And when I decide that I need to care for myself and sit back, enough's enough. You got to set those boundaries, right? So you can care for yourself and be peaceful. If your cup is empty, you have nothing to offer, right? So you're caring for yourself. Good job, you guys. Remember to do that. If you start to feel tired or you're saying yes too much, be like, oh no, I'm pretty chipper and blissful, but I'm drawing the line here. Thank you very much. So that's you guys. If you're new, don't forget to press like and subscribe. And there's a bell for notifications, and down below are all my links. If you press the little gray arrow for private reads, for notifications, for my Etsy store, for all the glimmy glams, and the crowns are up, all the fun stuff that you guys love. And thank you guys all so much for visiting my shop and purchasing my creations. I really, really appreciate it. I really value that. And it makes me really happy to know that you viewers own it. And most of you, I've had, you know, you're on Patreon now, and I've had conversations with you, and it's really lovely to interact with you on that level. And, you know, I do rituals with my stuff too, to make sure it's cleansed of all negative energy, and then I infuse it with a blessing, and I just do some nice ritualistic stuff with sage and stuff for it too, because I believe when it's like when you cook food with love, when you make things and create it with love, it carries a different energy to it for sure. So bless you guys, love you very much. So the next group is number two, the frog spirit. Clear out the clutter. So I'm hearing a lot of you guys, you're getting rid of the mental as well as the physical clutter. You're letting go of the past and you're releasing old hurts and bonds that no longer serve you. You also, if you have old newspapers, old junk and stuff, where you think, well, I might use that for that article this night. You're like, no, you know what? If I haven't looked at this thing in the last week, it's not pertinent to my life anymore. I could throw it out. Clean spaces and feng shui and having physical space helps you have mental space 100%, right? So here is, oh, look at how cute this is. Loyalty. Love that. I'm there for the people I care about in whatever way they need me. Ride to the airport, no problem. Bail out of jail, you bet. Go see your band again? Maybe. The point is, when I stand with them, I know I'm part of something special. And to be honest, it doesn't suck to look around and remember they're standing with me too. That's beautiful, right? Yeah, I mean, friendships endure because we're just present, right? We don't have to be the life of the party. We don't have to be the shining eternal thing. Just being present for there. You ever look out in a crowd and you see your best friend or a close friend's face? You know they're there, right? It's whatever, you know. That's like my friend Jeannie and Elaney. I'd go, if anybody needed anything, I'd get on a plane. I would be there in a heartbeat when if they needed me, because that's what life is about. It's about those connections, for sure. And you're going to have that. That's one of your areas of your life that's going to be improved. When you call on anybody, you're going to realize how much loyalty is around you. And it's going to be like, woo, I knew it. I was hoping and I knew it for sure. And being the joy and the light. And that's another thing. It's going to buoy you in your mood and make you feel better and feel loved and feel like you have the capacity for love and open, honest, integrity, ridden relationships, which is very important this day and age, because a lot of people can be vacuous and they disappear. They get what they want and they leave, right? It's all about being of sound, integrity-based behaviors for sure. So my friend just told me what this was called. Ixal. I think it's Ixal, right? Ixal. Medicine woman, you are a channel for divine healing power. That's another thing that you're going to have. You're going to find remedies very quickly for yourself and others. You're into natural medicine. Comment down below too if you try all kinds of teas and herbs and natural medicines, oils and all that. I feel like this group are natural medicine men and women. They know remedies. Pharmaceuticals come from plant-based derivatives. So why wouldn't we be able to heal ourselves with this stuff? Like turmeric. I keep hearing turmeric. Who's out there drinking turmeric? I hear you guys are turmeric people. Green tea. Okay, so cycles and rhythms. Humor the cycles of your body, energy levels, and emotions. That's another thing. Yeah, I'm hearing very clearly. You guys are going to understand when you need rest, you're going to take a rest. When you feel like you need more exercise and you need to get those endorphins going and your muscle tone working a little more, you're going to do that. You're going to care for yourself, because this vessel works. It's water. It's made up of water. It's made up of cells. It's made up of connective tissues, and it all needs certain vitamins, minerals, and care, right? And you're going to do that. You're going to be caring for yourself, which is really important, because when we cherish and love on ourselves and we know, you know, we're this cool jive little turkey and we need to treat our little giblets well, we need to eat well, we need to rest. My main thing is patience and to slow down, because being a Sagittarius, I will go and go and go. I was just going to make one video and then I made two. Now I'm making three. And then I took on some pro bono work and I'm doing other things. And I'm like, slow your roll. You've only had one day off since you've started this whole thing and it's not good. You know what I mean? So I do at the second half of the day, I don't touch anything or do anything for a while and I take it easy. You're going to be doing that too. You're going to feel the cycles and rhythms of your body and how they are affected in certain places, and you're going to care for yourself in that way. So that's very, very important. So that's you guys. Amazing. If you're new, don't forget to press like and subscribe. This is just a little quick thing, because these are just little reminders that, you know, this go around, we're in a human body, and you don't put crap gas in a beautiful machine, right? So don't fill your stuff with salt, sugar, and junk. It doesn't digest well. You want to be temperate and you want to care for yourself, right? I'm feeling a lot of you too. Check out that you have enough iron. Yeah, iron. If you're getting low on energy, that you have some iron in your B12s for your brain, for your brainium and your cranium. You got to keep that thing rocking, right? Because you want to be looking good and feel good. You want to be keeping it together and don't burn out. This is the season. I know I just hate to say this, but this holiday season, people just go and go and go. They shop and shop and shop. They get so excited. Guess what? Just act like it's everything's another day. And then you just, why would you burn yourself out for one day? You know what I mean? Then so many people just want to sleep on Christmas because they're like, oh, I'm so done with everything. Just feel light, happy, and free, and that's going to help you. Tell yourself, I have all the time in the world. Actually, time stretches out and becomes very cyclical when you do that, and it's not linear anymore, so you do have more because you realize how time works, and you're not compressed. You're expanding, so do that. That's you guys. If you're new, don't forget to press like and subscribe. All my links are down below if you guys need private reads. I've got everything down there. Patreon, my Etsy store with all my jewelry, the crowns. If you want to sparkle on out, go check stuff out. It's pretty cool. Thank you. Next is Lion Spirit. Be generous of spirit. That's you guys. I feel like you're this group before, where you felt a lack in certain things, a lack of time, a lack in finances. You're no longer feeling that because you realize the law of attraction is when you act as if you have a lot of money and you spend it freely, you know it's coming back to you. You give graciously of your time because you know that will be reciprocated. It's expansive. It's beautiful. It's connecting. Very good, you guys. Levity. I do need my gloss in this because it's white and white. This levity card speaks of, the lights are very peculiar. Laughter is the best legal medicine. Not like mushrooms and crystal meth and so syrup. And it looks like it's time for you to take a sweet, sweet hit of it. When someone annoys you or a plan goes awry, try finding something funny in there. And if you ever feel like the butt of the joke, remember that the only difference between someone laughing at you and someone laughing with you is that in the first version, you're not laughing. You always have the option. So opt to lighten up. It's legal in almost 200 countries. That's so cute. I love these. If you guys can get anything for Christmas for people, get these affirmators. They come in all different kinds too. These are loving relationships, but they have family and friends and work, and they're awesome. If I'm ever getting a little testy because I just burn the candle at both ends, I read these and I get in such a good mood because they're so silly, right? And that's why I think people are like, how are you almost 50 and you look like that? Or how can you do this and do this much during the day? And it's all sense of humor. Like, I see humor in everything, and I'm very, very lucky. My mom was super humorous. She was like Bette Midler, and she used to make me laugh. She was strong. I remember one time my dad came home, and it was years ago, and they were at Sweet Hall, and they had drank, and he was drinking and driving. And then all of a sudden, my mom comes out and was like, Warren Whitaker, were you drinking and driving? And he's laughing, and she was left-handed, left hook punches him right in the face, and he goes down the whole stairs, boom, 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 boom. And I remember there was this big chest with stuff at the bottom, and dad just poop, suck, just flat out, just dead, just passed out. And my mom's like, good night, Melanie. We go back in our perspective rooms. And I was like, girl, it's on. But I remember it was just like, you know, it was the 70s. It was like normal, but she was so funny. But you know what I mean? And that kind of shit was always going on in my house. So, and it was like a big commune almost, and everybody was everywhere. And it was just like, everybody was very accepting. And then my dad's first time, it was just everything. So that's why I'm able to be expansive and funny, because I've experienced such a goober nut life, right? Broken arrow, embrace the energy of peace. Yeah, you guys are also coming to a place where you're calm of heart. You step back and you're in receivership mode, and you're no longer chasing, trying to do. You realize busy is nothing. It means nothing. It means crap. It's not who you are. You want to be effective. And then once you're effective, you can sit back, rest, and be at peace and observe, because I feel like this group, they like to observe. They like to listen to music. You love nature channels. Comment if you like the blue planet and all that. I feel like you really like to take your time and savor. I feel a lot of Aquarians in this group, a lot of Libras, a lot of, you know, deep thinkers and dreamers in this group. And that's what you're doing. You're more at peace. You know, you're tired of, you're not in a rat race. And Freya, and boldness too. Absolutely. I feel that you guys too, you're speaking up for yourselves. You're not saying yes anymore when you mean no. You're not doing favors for people that don't do favors for you. You're not going above and beyond for people that won't do that for you. You've set your boundaries. You know what's what. You're watching. You know who's clapping when you win a prize, and you know who's not budging. You can see envy in others' eyes, and you move away from that. You don't really care for that. You are vibing out with your new tribe, who are happy, relaxed, legitimately authentic. It's giving you that peace, for sure. And austere, I love this fertility. It is the perfect time for you to start new projects, new ideas, and give birth to new conditions. Yeah, I feel like you guys too, you're gonna have a lot of vitality in your artistic fields. A lot of you guys, if you're singers, actors, writers, all those things, you're gonna get divine inspiration. You'd be like, wow, it's just flowing and flowing. I'm in that lane right now. I cannot do enough during the day. As soon as I put tarot down, I go and I get my paints. And if you want to go on the Patreon page, I'm going to list some up on there as well. If go to my Instagram as well, please come see me at sparkchrist11. I've got my artwork up there. It's so fun. You'll see the reads on there. It's crazy. It's really fun. Yeah, come check out on Instagram. I keep forgetting I do that. Like, I don't normally do stuff like that, but I'm like, I like to post when I get really cool cards and make recommendations. Facebook is more family oriented, but yeah, come see sparkchrist11. I'd like to show you guys some of the artwork. And that's going to be you. Your creativity is opened up. And also, I feel like a lot of you too that... You're coming into the element of you are ready also and prepared to start a family as well. You feel like you're at that point of life where you would I gotta breathe for a sec. All right. Yeah, some of you had struggles with fertility and now you don't. You're having breakthroughs. Things are happening for you. So that's amazing. That's you guys. Awesome, right? And remember, dude, just freaking be bold. Go out there and do what you want to do because a lot of you are at breakthroughs. You're looking good. You're in a blissful state. You're feeling blessed. And your gratitude is now opening those doors and ushering in those new things. So if you're new, don't forget to press like and subscribe and the notification bell for the new videos as well. If you go to the little gray arrow in the bottom, because people are always like, oh, Melnick, how do I find your reads? That little gray arrow, all the links will come up for personal reads, my Etsy store, the Patreon page, my Instantgo link. If you want a quick answer and a quick tarot read, I'm on there as well. So that's really fun. People like that a lot, especially if they're going on a date or they're going to be meeting a difficult person. I can pull some stuff out of the hat for you because I know how that is, right? My third eye is like, boom. I've done so many reads today. So if I stall out for a minute, just stay with me. This is group 4, elephant spirit. Elephant's my other spirit animal. I love elephants so, so much. Learn from the past, right? This is where you're going to be having breakthroughs. You're like, you're going to start a certain behavior pattern. You're going to go, holy crap, not this same old bag of peanuts. No way. I've done this before. How far did it get me? It didn't get me anywhere. Because guess what? When I go back and I try to relive the glory days, or I try to, I get stuck in a rut and I feel, I'm going to, you know, have all this sadness and miss this and get all dramatic. It's never worked for you. Or if you draw attention to you, if you're attention seeking, that doesn't work. You realize you'd rather do things humbly, honestly, in the right way now, because you're not competing. I feel like you have a lot of attention seekers around you, this group, and they aggravate you. So you sometimes feel like you aggression will squash it, and or you try to up the whole thing, and you're like, that doesn't work, and it's exhausting, so you're not doing it. Oh, boundless love. Oh, today I'll open my eyes a little wider and walk a little taller, noticing that the world around me is filled with tiny miracles. With this in mind, it's easy to fall in love over and over again with everything from honeybees to neon signs. And while I'm feeling this inspired and this in love, everything else sort of falls into place. I love that. Yeah, that's another thing. You're above the fray. You're no longer you're not big on jealousy, gossip, or any of those things that are lower vibrations, because it doesn't serve a purpose. What does it do? It talks ill of someone else, which usually comes back to bite anyone who does it in the ass. Plus, it makes them, I perceive people that do this, untrustworthy, because I feel like if they'll sit and partake in that gossip about them, they'll do it about you. There's a weird competitiveness or enviness that is the base of that. Otherwise, they wouldn't start that. We should all be here to elevate each other, especially women with women, to help each other to grow, to talk each other up, and to be our best selves, right? And air guardian, shift your perception. Yeah, that's also how you're perceiving. It's like you're changing your philosophy on a lot of things, and you have a wider sense of gratitude, and so your perception is different. When somebody comes from a place of love and helpfulness, you see that right away, because before, where you might have instinctually been like, well, what do they want from me? You're understanding that they're just being gracious and in their giving, and you're at this calmer place, and you realize that people, they want to help, and that they're loving, and that it's all part of the circumstances, right, of your new self and prosperity. The universe is pouring the abundance out to you. Be open to receiving. Yeah, this group as well. this group is starting to understand that in order to manifest and have the law of abundance, it's very, very easy when you just get in receivership mode. You stop the doubt. You stop the worry. You are thankful for what you have. You realize the abundance. You see all the beauty around you, the animals, the Christmas tree, all the decorations, the people, the light, the joy in other people's arms. I'm trying to think of the things. Everything just seems like sparkling and merry and joyful and you're just contented and delighted about what's around you. So the abundance is going to come in. Yeah. Yep. It's coming in. And look at Coventina, purification. It is a time for cleaning and detoxification in your body and soul. Yeah. You're also realizing that if you put garbage into your body, put in heavy salts and sugar, you're not going to feel well. You're not going to operate food. You're not going to operate with food that doesn't, that has empty calories. You want vitamins and stuff that help your brain function, that help your heart, your liver, all those things. So you're going to start eating stuff. You're going to start juicing and doing things that are good for you. And you're also going to remove any, I feel like you in the past, a few of you felt like you had to have the last word. It was like just one of those things where you had to get that last dig in because you're surrounded with people that like to be argumentative, some of you, and now you're just dismissing it and going, you know, that doesn't give me peace of mind. That makes me feel like I have to get worked up, and I'm not going gobble gobble with all the turkeys anymore. I'd rather just be in my blissful place, and the quicker I can get away from these a-holes, I can do my own thing, that sort of thing. I'm serious. You're in it to win it. You're recognizing who is who and who's an ally and who is for you and who helps you to your greater good. And those are the people you're going to stick with. And it is going to serve your higher purpose because you're going to care and value for yourself more as well too. And that means that you're going to be able to hone your craft in recognizing who's part of your tribe. And, you know, that's a big part of it. Once we recognize who's really there for us, wants to help us to strive and grow, we want to retain those friendships, right? It's very important. So yeah, that's about it on you guys. Yeah, you're making quantum leaps in a lot of these areas because once you realize, wow, this, when I come from honesty, when I am my authentic self, when I work with integrity and I see things through a loving lens, that's what comes back at me. You know, it's Albert Einstein's famous saying that when you see the world as threatening, harsh and cruel, that's what you experience. But when you see the world as loving, caring, and kind, that's what you experience. And that's the corner that you have turned. And that is the light that's now shining on you. So you're doing well. And you're going to feel it. You're going to feel all the little aches and pains disappear because you're in a new sort of sweet spot in your life, which is excellent. My tiara's getting heavy as F. I gots to go, my tiara. And I'm starving. So anyway, I love you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I really appreciate you guys watching, commenting, your subscribership. It means a lot. It helps the channel to keep going and thriving. Thank you for donations at this Christmas time because I really appreciate it. It's what I do now for my living for you guys. I love it. And I love you guys. And I love being able to channel and direct these messages that help you grow. And your comments are so loving and sweet. I mean, know that I think about you, know that I read every single comment and that I care about you because I really, really do. In fact, I do so much. I'm about to lose my voice, so I have to stop talking. I'm going to have a problem. Anyway, all my links are down below if you guys need a private read. And my, well, everything's on there. Instantgo, anything you can imagine, the Etsy store. Go check out the new jewelry. I have some cool stuff on there. I got all the crowns on there, so you can be razzle-dazzle. If you join Patreon, you get 50% off everything as well. So have a look at Patreon. I love you guys. Love and light. Take it easy and stop shopping. Go online and buy stuff online so you can have a break.